Hello everyone, this is Sheba. Today I want to talk about another topic on wickedness actually, because wickedness has been very rampant from the times God has created the world, and it will be there till the end of the world, which is second coming and, you know, and the destruction of the world, and a new city will be built, the new Jerusalem and new earth and all that. So. But wickedness is such a thing that is born in the core of man's heart, and when wickedness is you know, overthrown or it becomes too large, then God has to step in and then destroy the wicked people who are doing that wickedness. Okay, but what I found here is that even in wickedness, when they repent, God definitely, you know, changes his plan. But when wickedness is like a ripe fruit, and it goes from ripe to bad or sour, and which cannot be eaten, that's when God's judgment will fall on them. For that, let's look into Genesis 19, 3 to 10. Okay. Here we, most of us know about the story of Sodom and Gomorrah, how it was destroyed because of their wickedness. Now, because they were wicked, God wanted to destroy them. And actually, when the angels go to destroy that place to Lot, the people still had some actually chance to, you know, save themselves, but unfortunately they were so subdued, they were so immersed in their wickedness that these people did not, you know, heed or even have any kind of like goodness. Leave alone if they had little bit of godliness or goodness, God would have seen that and then not bring so much destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah, which is to ruins to this day, they say. So let's look at the story here. In Genesis 19, 3 to 10, I'll read to you. But he insisted so strongly that they did go with him and entered the house. He prepared a meal for them, baking bread without yeast, and they ate. Before they had gone to bed, all the men from every part of the city of Sodom, both young and old, surrounded the house. They called to Lot, "Where are the men who came to you tonight? Bring them out to use us so that we can have sex with them." Lot went out to meet them and shut the door behind him and said, "No, my friends, don't do this wicked thing. Look, I have two daughters who have never slept with a man. Let me bring them out to you and you can do what you like with them. But don't do anything to these men, for they have come under the protection of my roof." "Get out of our way," they replied. "This fellow came here as a foreigner and now he wants to play the judge. We'll treat you worse than them." They kept bringing pressure on Lot and moved forward to break down the door. But the men inside reached out and pulled Lot back into the house and shut the door. Then they struck the men who were at the door of the house, young and old, with blindness so that they could not find the door. See, here it is very, very serious. What happens is, you know, these wicked people wanted to actually have sex with the angels who had come to Lot's house, thinking that they were only but men. So, and they were so wicked that they were so drunk in their filthiness that they wanted to commit something like this. But you know, God was like, Lot pleads with them. And sometimes we see that, you know, good people want to rescue the wicked people from doing more wickedness so that they will not go to destruction. But here we see, but when that doesn't happen, when the wicked people don't take over or understand the goodness of the Lord or the godliness, what happens is they take their own their own wickedness to fall on them, which leads to destruction. So Here I want to emphasize that sometimes, you know, like Lot knew that they were very wicked, but he wanted to save these people and also save the people who, the wicked people in Sodom and Gomorrah. So if these people had understood what Lot was saying, or they were in a little bit of godly, or they were a little bit in wisdom and wise and not committing or doing anything wrong like that, they would have been saved. But what happens when they even try to pull Lot out of the door and wanted to commit that sin with the angels, whoever was at the door went blind. So it's this is what I wanted to tell you, and it is quite serious because in Genesis 19:24 it also says that that then the Lord rained down burning sulfur on Sodom and Gomorrah from the Lord out of the heavens. Thus he overthrew those cities and the entire plain, destroying all those living in the cities and all the vegetation in the land. But Lot's wife looked back and she became a pillar of salt. Now here the Lord, you know, he brought down burning sulfur, and he rained down burning sulfur on Sodom and Gomorrah. Where do we see this sulfur thing again? It is in hell. So what exactly happened, do you think, in Sodom and Gomorrah? They literally faced little bit of hell. In the hell, or under the earthquake, under the earth, during the earthquake or volcano's time, the sulfur just comes out like a lava, right? So that is nothing. That is nothing but tasting little bit of hell. So we have to be careful that God doesn't just, you know, show wicked people or the people who do bad or ignorant of God's ways just to go out and then do what they want to do, or, you know, escape and all that, because God does show hell on earth. Why do people of all religions, for that matter, you know, believe that God is going to punish them? Because everybody knows that God is a just God, and he despises wickedness. So here in Sodom and Gomorrah also, when these people wanted to, you know, they were filth, they were wicked to the core, and then they wanted to commit all, they were already committing all kinds of sins. And when the chance came for them, at least, you know, to avoid these people and said, okay, fine, we will not, you know, commit any sin with them, maybe God would have taken a second thought in destroying Sodom and Gomorrah, but not so. So what I want to emphasize here is, when wickedness takes over one's heart, one's mind, one's body, spirit and soul, that wicked man or that wicked family or that wicked man and woman will bring destruction automatically on them. And they will be destroyed. So here we see sulfur, and sulfur is nothing but it's fire, you know. And they have said that in hell there is sulfur. The smell of that smoke and fire is sulfur in hell. So God showed hell on the earth to such wicked people. So what I'm trying to say here is, we all have to be very, you know, reverent, and know that God can pour out his sulfur, pour out his fire, pour out his burning, you know, rain down hell from heaven on the wicked people. So it's not just that when a person dies is going to see either heaven or hell. No, it's not that. They are going to see here. They are going to experience hell on earth, because the very example that we have seen in Sodom and Gomorrah is that God rained down sulfur, it says. So, and it was like only fire and coal. So people were literally burned to ashes. And the city doesn't exist today at all. They know that it is Sodom and Gomorrah, but there is no vegetation, there is no plant life, there is no animal life. You know, it is just like devastation. It is like everything has been dried up. So when God can do that in today's world, We have to be very careful because we have to know that God is the same God yesterday, today, and forever. So whatever we do, we have to do for the glory of God. But if we do it for our own selfish motives, or if someone does, you know, things that they want to do because of their wickedness, then they have to pay the price, because he's a God of love and mercy and grace too. But he doesn't forgive when you don't listen. When someone doesn't listen about God, you know, knowing God, they don't listen to God, then it is a big thing. Knowing God and you don't listen to God, then it is a big thing, you know. So people have to be very careful. When you commit something, you commit to the Lord. If it is not in His will, don't do it. If it is in His will, then know that He is your God and He's guiding your steps. But if He stops you from doing any kind of wickedness, stop there, because He is God, right? He created you. When He can create you, when He has created you, He will know how to destroy you too. So we have to be very careful of how we deal and conduct our lives before God, because ultimately we worship God, the Yahweh, Jesus, you know, a mighty God, El Shaddai. So that is what I wanted to, you know, let you know. And may the Lord bless this word. Thank you.